It seems like only yesterday that Ali Raisman and the Fierce Five captured the gold and the hearts of America at the 2012 Summer Olympics in London. Two members of that quintet, Raisman and Gabby Douglas, returned to the Games in Rio in 2016, along with Simone Biles, Lori Hernandez, and Madison Koshin, to create the Final Five and capture U.S. Olympic gold once again. But for Raisman, post-Olympic life has involved more grueling trials and high-profile victories than she ever experienced in competition. Here is the untold truth of this inspiring athlete. Sleeping on it. If you're anything like Raisman, you're thinking about taking a nap right now. The six-time Olympic medalist told People, "My teammates all joke they call me grandma because I love my sleep so much." Perhaps it shouldn't come as a surprise, then, that she became an ambassador for online mattress company Lisa, which is reportedly committed to giving back to those in need. According to Fast Company in 2017, Lisa donates one mattress to a nonprofit shelter for every 10 sold, over 23,000 so far, and they plant a tree for every mattress sold. Online dating. During the 2016 Olympics in Rio, Raisman acquired an adoring fan club, and Oakland Raiders tight end Colton Underwood was one of its most ardent members. Underwood asked Raisman out with a video message. Former Olympic gymnast and wife of one of Underwood's teammates, Sean Johnson, helped orchestrate the ask.
"Just want to congratulate you on all your success. If you're ever in San Jose and want to go on a double date with me and Andrew and Sean, let me know."
Raisman agreed, tweeting, "Thanks for the sweet video. Looking forward to meeting you." Unfortunately for Underwood, he couldn't stick the landing. Their relationship fizzled out 6 months later. But Underwood tells the Journal Star that they're still good friends. No shame. A longtime advocate for body positivity, Raisman has no patience for body shaming.
"It's really an amazing thing to kind of test your body to see what you can do, and it's a really great feeling of accomplishment when you leave the gym every single day and you're just completely exhausted."
In May 2017, she took to Twitter to lash out at a TSA agent for allegedly disparaging her appearance. "Lady at TSA, gymnast? I recognize you by your biceps. Man at TSA? I don't see any muscles and continues to stare at me. He was very rude, staring at me, shaking his head like it couldn't be me because I didn't look strong enough to him? Not cool." Those tweets then got the attention of the TSA, who responded in a statement. "We conduct screening at security checkpoints when departing from a U.S. or U.S. territory airport, and it appears that Ms. Raisman was traveling from a foreign airport. We have reached out to Ms. Raisman via Twitter. We look forward to hearing from her to look into this further." Of course, there's much more to Ali Raisman than being one of the United States' best athletes. For years, she and other members of the USA Gymnastics team endured abuse while visiting with the team's doctor, Larry Nassar. Since lending her voice and testimony to the criminal case that finally put Nassar behind bars for the rest of his life, Raisman has become an outspoken advocate for victims of sexual abuse, both within and outside of the athletic community. Speaking out. A day before, disgraced former USA Gymnastics doctor Larry Nassar was initially sentenced to 40 to 175 years in prison for decades of sexual abuse, Indiana Congresswoman Susan Brooks tweeted a photo of herself with USA Gymnastics President Carrie Perry. Raisman immediately fired back about the tone-deaf post. "Susan Brooks, to tweet support to USA Gymnastics the day before his sentencing makes me sick. You obviously have not done your research and taken the time to understand that USA Gymnastics enabled a pedophile for decades, the worst in history of all sports. I ask you to stand with the survivors." Brooks' office responded with a statement explaining that the meeting with the new USA Gymnastics president was about a shift in culture that would happen through the Protecting Young Victims from Sexual Abuse Act. "Congresswoman Brooks is proud to be leading this bipartisan effort in the House to make sure that young people in the future can pursue their Olympic dreams in a safer and healthier environment." The sentencing. During Nassar's sentencing, nearly 160 women and girls came forward to confront him and share their stories with the court. But initially, Raisman didn't want to be one of them. She tweeted, "I will not be attending the sentencing because it is too traumatic for me. My impact letter will be read in court in front of Nassar. I support the brave survivors. We are all in this together. #StopAbuse." But after witnessing the strength of her fellow survivors in the courtroom, Raisman made her appearance in court on January 19, 2018.
"Larry, you do realize now that we, this group of women you so heartlessly abused over such a long period of time, are now a force, and you are nothing."
Calling for more. On January 24, 2018, Michigan Judge Rosemarie Aquilina sentenced Nassar to 40 to 175 years in prison.
"I just signed your death warrant."
While that judgment ensures Nassar will never prey on anyone else, Raisman believes the punishment is not enough. Someone brought this up the other day, and they said he's going to jail for almost like a year for each survivor. So when you put it in that perspective, it's really not enough. According to CNN, as of February 2018, Nasser has since received two additional sentences, another 40 to 175 years for sexual abuse and 60 years in federal prison for child pornography. While those terms will be served concurrently, he's expected to serve a minimum of 100 years behind bars. Raisman vs. USA Gymnastics. On ESPN's investigative series Outside the Lines, Raisman claimed USA Gymnastics ignored her allegations against Nasser and implied that the organization issued a threat to keep her silent. Raisman told ESPN,
"There was an investigation going on. They told me to be quiet, and I thought that they were doing the right thing, and I didn't want to tip off the investigation. I trusted them, and I shouldn't have."
When asked about USA Gymnastics' statement claiming to support, quote, "the young women who have courageously stepped forward," Raisman was having none of it. She said,
"Every single time they release a statement, it's basically the same thing, saying they care. If they really cared, then there would be a lot of change, and there has not been enough change."
A modern-day hero. The messages of the Me Too and Time's Up movements were fully embedded into the 2018 Women's March, where millions of women took to the streets around the world. One of the 200,000 in attendance in New York City was singer Halsey. In a powerful poem, she shared her own story of sexual assault and directly referenced Raisman's bravery in court.
"But then heroes like Ashley and Simone and Gabby, Michaela and Gaga, Rosario, Allie, remind me this is the beginning, it is not the finale, and that's why we're here, and that's why we rally."
Thanks for watching. Click the Nikki Swift icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love, too.